In this session, we are going to see what are the differences between the conventional C programming that you might have learned on the computers and what is the Arduino programming and where does it stand. So let's begin. Now, if you have done any amount of C programming or if you are even remotely knowing about the C coding, then you must be familiar with this structure where we just hash include a library, something like stdio.h. Then we write down the program in the body void main, and whatever is the executable of our C code, we write all that down here into these two curly brackets. Whereas, as you have seen in our last session, in Arduino, we don't do like this. We haven't included any hash include yet. We haven't written void main. Instead, what we wrote was void setup and then void loop. So, there was no printf actually in case of Arduino. I'm just keeping it here for illustration. So, what we do here is we do something like pin mode or something. And here what we do is something like digital write or anything like that. Now, what is the difference between these two things? First of all, remember the language is C programming itself, but the Arduino folks have just converted it into, instead of writing a single void main function, they have complexed or they have just sliced that part in their compiler to be accepted as two functions. So one will be void setup and one will be void loop. Now again, why that is done, let me tell you. Because before Arduino, how people used to write down program in embedded world was also exactly the same. So hash include anything that you need, and then you write down void main, and then whatever is the initialization code, or what you may call it as setup code, what's supposed to be written here. And then when you want to start the main program, it has to be done like this. So while one structure was very famously used, because it's a constant, so it always remains true. And whatever is the executable code was being written at this particular point. So this is also the same format which is being followed by many microcontroller programming even at this point and will remain the same. But what happens is many a times beginners find it difficult what to write down above while one and what to write down below while one. What needs to be executed once and what needs to be executed infinitely or repeatedly. There is some doubt in the programmer's head, especially the beginner ones. And that is why the Arduino is split into these two bodies, void setup and void loop. Apart from that, there is no difference. Of course, in Arduino, you can have hash includes if you want to add any additional library or any built-in library or any custom-made library. So, that's about the basic programming structure. Second thing is about the data types. If you have known about C, good. If you have not known about C, just listen to this slide and it will get more clear when we are doing the programming. So data type is something which we use or declare while doing the C programming in order to save some piece of data. We also call it as a variable. Say I want to measure temperature, then I want to save that temperature into some value or some variable. And that variable has to be declared using some of the predefined or allowed data types. Basically, data types does what? Let's say if I declare char temp, then it will do what? It will allocate 8-bit of memory inside the RAM of my computer for the variable temp. Now that is data type. So if you declare something as int LED, then it allocates 16-bit space for that particular variable called LED inside my RAM. So that's the data type, and there are a number of data types in C. These are the data types which are provided by Arduino. So the int is 16-bit here on computers. Here in this discussion, our computer is Arduino. When you're talking about C compiler, regular C compiler, your computer is actually the Pentium processor or AMD processor or whichever you're using, which is much faster and much bigger architecture than Arduino. Arduino is small, 8-bit controller. So the variables are according to that 8-bit only. So byte is an 8-bit, char is an 8-bit, unsigned char is an 8-bit, char is signed, unsigned char of course is unsigned. Similarly, word or int are 16-bit. Usually on computer programming language, word and int are 32-bit ones, but here they are 16-bit ones. Then unsigned long is there, which is 32-bit unsigned data type. Long is there, which is signed data type, and float is there. So these are the most popularly and most commonly used data types in C as well as in Arduino. But in Arduino, the definitions are a bit different. Byte is same, char is same, but int and some other data types length may be different. All you need to assume, most of the times what we do is we either make use of char or int or long or float. This is just to demonstrate the similarity. There is no big difference between embedded C and the regular C programming language that we use onto our computers. The coding structure is exactly like C. So there are for loops, there is if condition, there are nested ifs, there is switch statement, there is while loop, functions as you write down in C, pointers as you use in C, arrays, structures, unions, even the libraries, hash includes, macros which you declare using hash define. Every single piece of the coding structure remains exactly the same. There is no change in coding structure. So whatever, if you have learnt about C before, good. Even if you don't have learnt about C, better. We will be explaining anything and everything as needed. But whatever that is present in C programming is exactly present into the Arduino also. So there is no change in the structures. The change lies where it lies in the libraries like stdio.h, conio.h. Now these are the standard input output libraries written in C for computerized programming, which does has an input device, which does has an output device. But since we don't have display, we don't have stdio.h or even printf, put s or put char functions. We don't have a keyboard connected to Arduino, so we don't have scanf, gets or getch kind of functions. We have a very small 8-bit brain, and that's why we don't have these heavy libraries like stdio.h or conio.h present inside the Arduino. But yes, we can do the bitwise IO operation, like making particular bits go high and low. Then we can perform serial communication, and we can print data exactly like we print on a computer screen by sending through our USB cable to the computer through serial communication. Then there is SPI and I2C communication. These are again some electronic serial communication protocols. We'll be discussing about them also in detail. We can do analog to digital conversion. We can convert any analog signal into digital version of it using the built-in analog to digital converter pins of Arduino. And we can also perform PWM signal generation. Means we can generate square waves from any pin of Arduino through the programming. But advanced things like a native display and keyboard inputs are not present there. So those are the things that are absent. And what are the constraints while doing the programming? The variables always take the RAM space, and the entire program that you write down, and as you have seen in last video, we upload it onto the board, it is stored into the flash space. So because of the RAM and flash space constraints, the thing becomes a bit tricky. See why? That is because Arduino Uno has got only 32 KB of flash and merely 2 KB of RAM on 5 volt operation. Now imagine you doing programming on your computer which has got maybe 8 GB, 16 GB or 32 GB of RAM. Arduino has 2 KB of RAM. So that's why any variable that you declare has to be justified. If your program is lengthy, if your program is a longer one, then you need to make sure you choose the variables carefully. For example, if there are LEDs that needs to be turned on and off and you want to assign a number to them, if possible, instead of using word or int, make use of char, because it will take only 8 bit of space inside the memory and it can store 0 to 255 or minus 128 to 127 numbers. So these are the constraints that you need to take care of while doing the programming in Arduino, but rest of the things almost remains the same between C programming and Arduino. Thanks for watching this video. Keep experimenting.